Now, consider these are some questions under the Fourier series topic. Under the Fourier series topic, first question, write out all these questions. First question, first condition they have given, f of t equal to minus f of t plus or minus t by 2, minus t plus or minus f of t plus or minus t by 2, then the options they will give you, in the options the Fourier series coefficient ck having the both cosine and sine, this having all harmonics like that they will give you, but given this is the condition for the what, half wave symmetry means the signal is, the spectrum will have only odd harmonics, spectrum will having only odd harmonics. Okay, this statement we have seen in many problems. Suppose if the statement is given like this, f of t equal to instead of plus, we have plus here, instead of minus, earlier it equal to f of t equal to minus f of t plus or minus t by 2, only odd harmonics will be present. If the condition is satisfied, like given is like this, f of t equal to f of t plus or minus t by 2, then the signal will be having the even harmonics only. We are very much familiar with this statement. In examination, they will give you like this, f of t plus or minus t by 2. We have to observe whether they are given minus or plus. If it is minus, then the signal is having only odd harmonics. As we know already, here it is equal to plus, the spectrum may having the only even harmonics instead of odd harmonics. All odd harmonics are going to be 0. Now, next question. The periodic signal f of t is represented with the trigonometric Fourier series. End of the question. This periodic signal f of t is represented using the trigonometric Fourier series expansion. In that, A is the amplitude of the fundamental harmonic component. And P is the peak value of the signal f of t. A is the amplitude, that is nothing but maximum value of the fundamental component, and P is the peak value of the signal f of t. Then some options they will give you. Options they are concentrating about the maximum amplitude of the first fundamental harmonic component and the peak value of the signal f of t they are asking. Okay, in options they are having p less than a, p greater than a, p may be equal to a, like that, and they are concentrating about the effective value of the p and effective value of a. Suppose listen, the trigonometric Fourier series representation is like that only, f of t is equal to some dc component plus a into f1 of t, that is fundamental component, plus b into f2 of t, trigonometric Fourier series or whatever, in Fourier series representation, okay, Fourier series representation, it is the combination of the dc signal and the harmonics only, fundamental component and the first harmonic, second harmonic, like that, so this is the representation of the signal is like this, f of t equal to dc plus a into f of t plus something. They are saying that A is the maximum value of this signal, amplitude of the signal f1 of t, and the corresponding peak value of the signal is equal to p, peak value of the signal is equal to p. So overall you can write this p is equal to simply, if you neglect the dc also, if you consider this p is equal to simply a plus b plus c plus, like that, if this b and c values are negative, then p may be less than a. If all b and c are positive, p may be greater than a. So there is a case that the peak value of this may be greater than a or may be equal to a also. If all this component is going to be 0, then peak value is equal to a also possible. These conditions may be possible. Now consider the effective value, that is nothing but RMS value. Effective value is nothing but RMS value point of view. This is equal to simply, if you have the expression like this, p square is equal to a square by 2 plus b square by 2 plus c square by 2, like that you will have. Okay, even b and c values are negative because of this square, they always be positive. Because of this pair, this always be positive only. So p square is, or effective value of this p is always greater than the effective value of the fundamental component. So from this we can say this effective value is always greater than the effective value of f of t is always greater than the effective value of fundamental component f1 of t. This condition is always true. This condition may or may not be greater than a or p less than a, or p is equal to a. On this, based on these two options, some options are available. From those options, we can select the suitable option. Suitable option by seeing, we can say the peak value may or may not greater than the fundamental component. Amplitude of the fundamental component, but the effective value is always greater than. Always greater than. Don't think any new question it is. Then given some signal f of t, which is a periodic signal f of t, the one period information they have given like this, a periodic signal f of t, then they are asking the magnitude of this A3 is equal to how much? Magnitude of the A3 is equal to how much? So fundamental signal they have given. Okay, I told you many times, if one period information they have given, try to form the total signal at least with the three periods. At least the three periods. Then what is the signal we can get? Like this, right? Right or wrong? Right. By extending to 2 watts, then whatever the nature of the signal after that, immediately by drawing this with the 2 periods, then immediately what you have to do? We have to verify whether the given signal is the odd, even, or satisfying the half asymmetry. If not satisfying anything, then can you make some any modifications to make the signal as a odd signal or even signal or half asymmetry by adding some DC signal. Already we have seen, by directly seeing, this is looking like a odd signal, right? Looking like a odd signal. So odd signal means in the spectrum it is having only sine harmonics, nothing but B terms only, B1, B2, B3, like that only. Okay, this A3 means this belongs to the cosine term. Cosine terms are not available. So not only this A3, A1, A2, A3, A4, whatever the value is equal to 0 only. Whatever the value is equal to 0 only, don't try to calculate blindly by making 1 by T0, 0 to T0, it is for something. This magnitude by considering some a, some minus a, like that. Okay, just in Fourier series, if they are commenting about the magnitude of the particular harmonic, immediately first we have to do is the verification. A verification about the signal f of t is a even, odd, half asymmetry. What is the characteristic is having? First one. The second one is that, can we convert by adding some DC value, can we convert the given signal into the odd signal or even signal or half asymmetry signal? Okay, after that only comment on this. Maximum of the questions in the gate point of view, they will give you like that only. They will give you like that only. Then, next question, simple question. What is the second harmonic? Next one is that, what is the second harmonic? What is the second harmonic of this one? 10 sine 10 sine 2 pi 100 t. What is the second harmonic they are asking? As we know, the cosine signal is this is the sinusoidal signal. 10 sine 100 pi t is the sinusoidal signal. Sinusoidal signal means it is having the spectrum, it is having only one fundamental component, nothing but first harmonic only. They are asking the second harmonic. So the first one is signal, second harmonic in this one is equal to 0 only, second harmonic in this signal is equal to 0 only, or otherwise the signal is given a sinusoidal signal. In the Fourier series, the first the sinusoidal signal is given, immediately express that into the phasor form as e power j theta minus j theta by 2j. From that also, we can observe the spectrum is having only one frequency, the corresponding is equal to 2 pi into 100, fundamental frequency which is equal to 2 pi into 100 only. The corresponding frequency they are asking, then this is equal to 100 Hz only. 100 Hz, this frequency only exists. So they are asking of second harmonic may not exist. So the answer value is equal to 0. Coming to this one, this f of t they have given is like this. One period information they have given. They are asking some options like spectrum is having both cosine and sine, positive DC and cos, negative DC and cos, positive DC and sine, like that they are asking. Just now we have seen one question. If whenever one period information is given, just try to draw the signal with at least with the two periods information. First, I don't know signal with the two period information. Here is the periodic signal, period from 0 to t. This is one period information. This is your one period signal. Draw neatly. After that only we can observe. We can comment about the even or odd or half asymmetry or anything. This is your vertical axis. This is the signal they have given. So the next period of the signal can be drawn like this. Amplitude is equal to here, it is equal to here, and here it is equal to -2a. How can you comment whether the given signal is the even or odd? To comment about the even signal, even or odd, first of all, we have to have the symmetry with respect to the x-axis. That is nothing but here amplitude is equal to a, here amplitude is equal to minus 2a. We have to make these two amplitudes are equal by doing some modification I am doing by seeing. Because by seeing this by By seeing itself, this is not a neither even. This is a neither even nor odd signal. Neither even nor odd signal. By doing some modification means by adding some DC value, whether can we change this to the even or odd signal or off the symmetric signal, we have to verify. Always our how can you modify? How can you add the DC signal to make? So the what is the width of this one? This simply is equal to a into minus 3a, which is equal to 3, which is equal to 3a. 3a by 2 is equal to 1.5a. We have to modify this signal to be like this. We have to modify this signal only the positive amplitude should be 1.5 and negative amplitude should be minus 1.5. Positive amplitude should be 1.5 and negative amplitude should be minus 1.5. Like this we have to modify. Like this, you have to modify 1.5 and my not a new thing. Many questions we have seen already. Similar questions we have seen already. Okay, this is your f of t. This is your f of the g of t. I am taking g of t. So this f of t can be represented as minus 0.5 plus g of t. Minus 0.5 plus g of t. By adding this minus 0.5, this will become a. This will become a. And minus 0.5, this will become minus 2a. Minus 2a. So f of t can be represented as like this. Like this, you have to modify. Just simple observe this difference to my a minus of minus 2a, 3a. Take off part of this one. This is 1.5, 1.5a. Positive side, we have to get 1.5a. Negative side, we have to get the minus 1.5. By adding what value, you will get this like. You will get this type of input, this type of signal. That also we have to verify. This is your corresponding period t. This is your corresponding t here. By seeing now, this signal is of the what nature? This signal is of the what? Even only. Okay. But you how can verify? Moving in this side and moving in this side, having the same amplitude of the same duration. This is your t by 2 and this is your t by 4, this is your minus t by 4. Okay, after that this value is the same. And after that, even verification of the even is over. Okay, this signal is even. Then one more verification we have to do for every question. What was that? About the half wave symmetry. For half wave symmetry, we'll consider half of this period as one imaginary line, and from that we have to verify. By moving in this way, here is the negative value, here is the positive value. After crossing this one, here is the positive value, here is the negative value. Definitely it satisfies the half wave symmetry, which half wave symmetry equal to f of t plus or minus t by 2. Many questions we have done, no problem. We are still having doubt, revise the previous class. Minus f of t plus or minus t by 2. So this signal satisfies the even and half wave symmetry. The signal g of t satisfying the nature even and half wave symmetry because of this even. It is having only cos terms. DC along with the cos terms. Now it is satisfying the half wave symmetry also because of this half wave symmetry. This spectrum g of t is having only odd harmonics, so DC also will be nullified because DC we can consider as the even frequency. n equal to 0 is always we consider as the even number only. Okay, the DC also will be eliminated. So g of t is having cos with odd harmonics only. So the function f of t may having the cos functions along with the negative DC. This DC appeared from the modification. So the corresponding DC value equal to minus 0.5, which is negative DC, and is having the cos and is having the cos functions. It is not a new question actually. It is simply a revised question only. Still you are having any doubt, revise the previous class, Fourier series class carefully. This topic is very, very important. This type of questions only will expect in the examination. Next, after that, coming to this one, the signal f of t is periodic in nature. The corresponding spectrum of the exponential Fourier series coefficient is given as like this. And we have to comment about the signal f of t. In options they have given, f of t is real, f of t is not real. And we cannot say from the given information. But these type of questions, always they have given about the over the spectrum of the CK, we have to verify whether the condition is satisfying the magnitude condition and the angle condition. What is your magnitude condition? Magnitude of the CK is equal to C minus K. Magnitude of CK is equal to C minus K. And angle of CK is equal to minus angle of C minus K. If those conditions are satisfying, definitely the signal f of t is real in nature. If these conditions are not satisfying, we cannot say the f of t as a real signal. F of t as a real signal. Observe here, the corresponding is equal to C1 is equal to 1. So magnitude of C1 is equal to 1, which is equal to magnitude of C minus. So magnitude condition is satisfying. Magnitude of C2 is equal to 3 and magnitude of C minus 2 is equal to 3. So this condition, magnitude condition, is satisfying. Coming to angle condition, a very important question. Listen carefully. Listen carefully. So angle of the C1 is equal to pi here, and angle of minus C1 is equal to pi. So angle of C1 is equal to angle of minus C1. The angle condition is not satisfying. So the Kevin signal f of t is not a real signal. Like this, we can take. Listen. So you can, from this information, you can write this C1 is equal to magnitude of C1 into angle of C1, right? Magnitude of C1 is equal to 1 and angle of C1 is equal to e to the power j minus pi. So e power minus j pi, this value is equal to minus 1. C1 is equal to minus 1. And coming to this one, the corresponding C minus 1. Also, magnitude is equal to 1 and angle is equal to this one. We have this equal to minus 1. I am writing this minus 1 as a e to the power j pi. Why can't I write this minus 1 as e power j pi? I am writing instead of e power minus, from the spectrum they have given this 1 into e power minus j pi, which is equal to minus 1. I am writing this c minus 1 equal to e to the power j pi, whether it's correct or wrong. Correct only. So we can modify, I can make equal this spectrum to be like this one. At minus, at 1 we have angle is equal to minus pi, and at minus 2 we can take the corresponding angle is equal to pi, because e power j pi equal to minus 1 only. Similarly, at 2 this is equal to minus pi. At 2 I can consider this as the minus, this as the pi. So now the coordinate, the angle of C1 is equal to pi, minus pi, and the corresponding angle of C minus 1 is equal to pi. So angle of C1 is equal to angle of minus C1. This is satisfying. So we can represent this angle spectrum either like this or like this. The meaning is same only. Indirectly, this is looking like not satisfying the angle criteria of CK, but by doing some modification, this is doing satisfying. So this is satisfying both magnitude and the angle criteria. So definitely f of t is the real signal. This is the beauty of pi. I told to you already. Be careful about the e to the power j pi value. I told to you already in the basics of the signal system classes. Wherever you are having pi, you have to be careful. Because e to the power j pi is equal to 1, and e to the power minus j pi is also minus 1. It's minus 1, and e power minus j pi also minus 1. The angle may be pi or minus pi also. The value is equal to 1 or minus 1 only. Right. Next one. Coming to this one. Signal s of t is given as like that, which is to be convolved with cos square 4 pi into something. Then what are the output frequency components present? In the output of this signal or result of this signal? Whatever. Like this shape of cosines will appear. Many times I told you. Simply we have to concentrate what? Where? The convolution is in the time domain or multiplication domain. Here the convolution is in the time domain, right? Convolution in the time domain. There should be multiplication in the frequency domain. The s of t they have given as a periodic signal. We have to verify what are the spectral components present. Generally, periodic signal spectral components present are the omega naught, n omega naught, I mean 2 omega naught, 3 omega naught, like that. Here omega naught is equal to simply 2 pi by t. Omega naught is equal to 2 pi by t, which is equal to 2 pi divided by 0.1 milli, which is equal to 20 pi k. This is the fundamental component present, 20 pi k, and after that 40 pi k, like that. So the spectrum of the signal is present at the 20 pi k and 40 pi k and 60 pi k, like that. Whatever, if you satisfying even signal or signal, that is another thing. First basic thing is that it is the corresponding frequency components in the spectrum are here minus 20 pi k, 40 pi k, minus 40 pi k, like that. minus 45 k like the series of spectrum ck ck. Now this spectrum should be multiplied with the cos square 4 pi 10 cube t. What is the what about the component present in this one? This can be represented as simply 1 plus cos 8 pi into 10 cube t. 8 pi into 10 cube t divided by 2 divided by 2 divided by 2. So the signal is having the corresponding signal is having the DC signal. The corresponding signal is having the DC signal along with the component at 8 pi k and at minus 8 pi k. Don't bother about the magnitude. They are asking simply what are the frequency components present in the output of this signal. Present in the output result of this signal. So this is the spectrum, rough spectrum of this S of t and the cos square this one. So you have to multiply these two signals. We have to multiply these two signals because there was a convolution in the time domain. Upon multiplication, what is done? In the result that we are having the some signal at the DC, at omega equal to 0, we are having some signal. Here also omega equal to 0, we are having some signal. Some signal will appear like this, some signal will appear like this. And at 8 pi k, the corresponding value is equal to here is equal to 0, so here is equal to 0, and here is equal to 0. And all the frequency components 40 k, 60 k, 80 k, 80 pi k, whatever, some magnitude present here, there was no magnitude present in this one. So the corresponding, upon multiplication, the corresponding sample values are 0 only. So in the result of the signal, we are having only DC component only, DC only, okay, like this only. DTFT also, we have seen some cosines. In DTFT also, we have seen some cosines. They have given some signal. Okay, we have to verify, we have to calculate them. Values of n, wherever the values of n, the corresponding frequency components are, if n is equal to 2, corresponding are 2 omega naught is the frequency spectrum. Okay, we have to multiply the spectrum with the given spectrum because of convolution in the time domain. So the resultant signal is having only, DC component only. Like that. In this question only, they will ask you, what is the magnitude of the third harmonic component, like that also they can ask you. What is the magnitude of some question they will give you, like this cos 16 pi kt, some b into cos 16 pi kt, what is the value of b they can ask you. 16 pi kt means in 16 pi kt available, and there is not available, the 16 pi kt component is not available in the output of the signal. So the corresponding value b is equal to 0, like that only they will ask you. They can ask you what is the DC value. They can ask you DC value is nothing but simply here DC value is equal to 1 by 2. This 1 by 2 to be multiplied with the this DC value. How can you calculate this DC value? DC value means area under 1 period. Simply 1 by T area under 1 period. Okay, by multiplying these two, we can get the corresponding value also. Then next one. Simply by giving the question, we have to think convolution. Based on the convolution, convolution is determined. Whether in time domain or in the frequency domain, that we have to verify before attempting the question. Okay, right. Then next one. They have given AK is equal to 2. This way, this is also a very beautiful question. This AK is equal to 2 for K equal to 0. Write down or put it as a 2 stars. AK is equal to 2 for K equal to 0. And this is equal to J into 1 by 2 whole to the power mod K otherwise. Then we have to comment about the x of t. First option is x of t is real. Second option is x of t is even. And third option is dx of t by dt is odd. Fourth option is both b and c. Here what they have given? They have given the exponential Fourier series coefficient. AK is the exponential Fourier series coefficient, not a new thing. AK is the exponential Fourier series coefficient as like your CK. What are the conditions we are having for f of t? F of t is real and even. The corresponding CK is also real and even. If f of t is real and odd, already you know, not a new thing. Okay, just I am revealing here. Okay, real and odd. Then what about the CK? This is imaginary. And odd. Up to this we have reason. We know. Here AK they have given as the imaginary. Don't bother about this DC value. AK they have given is the imaginary. J into 1 by 2 whole to the power mod K. AK is equal to J into 1 by 2 whole to the power. J 1 by 2 whole to the power mod K they have given. We have to verify this is imaginary, no doubt at all. So CK is imaginary, no doubt at all. For imaginary nothing but f of t should be real and odd and satisfy imaginary and odd also. And odd also here, if you consider f of k as 1 by 2 whole to the power mod k, number 2 whole power mod k, then f of minus k is equal to 1 by 2 whole to the power mod minus k, this is equal to 1 by 2 whole to the power mod k only, which is equal to f of k only. But this is not satisfying the condition of this odd condition. This is imaginary. Imaginary, of course, imaginary. It is not satisfying odd condition. This is imaginary and even. This is imaginary and even. The corresponding f of t is may not real. The corresponding f of t is the imaginary and even. Imaginary and even. Even. And one more condition is imaginary and odd, then the corresponding ck is the real and odd. Corresponding ck is the real and odd. This is the continuation of this table. We have to take this one and put it as a note. Put it as a note. Okay, f of t is real and even, the corresponding ck is this one. Up to now you know. Here in this question they have given ck is the imaginary. Imaginary, but the corresponding term is the even. Corresponding term is the even. So the f signal f of t is the imaginary and even. Signal f of t is the imaginary and even. So the second option may be correct. X of t is even. If x of t is even, the differentiation of it is definitely odd. So both and c is the correct answer. Both b and c is the correct answer. Okay, take this as a note and put three stops to this one. In multiple choice also, I mean in matching point of view also, this question may be available. This type of question may be available. Match f of t they will give and ck the conditions are given in the zigzag way. You have to arrange in the particular way. Next one. Ck is equal to 10 divided by, I'm writing here again, ck is equal to 10 divided by 3 mod k plus 3 by kj for mod k less than 3 and k not equal to 0. For k is equal to 0, this value is equal to 10. K is equal to 0, this value is equal to 10. What is the power of the even of x of t they are asking? They are not asking the power of the total signal, power of the even of x of t. Power of, you are feeling this session is going on fast, just pass that left, the pass that place wherever you are getting confusing, just analyze about the topic, that's it. It is a recording session, no problem. You can pause, you can anywhere. Or you can revert. You can go to back also. Wherever you are feeling any confusion, you can go to back and think, analyze. Should you are having any doubt, call to this number. Okay, don't leave many times. Don't read, the class are going on very fast like that. At the same time, don't feel the class is going on very slow. If the class is going on very slow, just we can do fast forward. If you are feeling the class is going on fast, just we can go back, right? CK they have given 10 by 3 mod k plus 3 by k j. In the signal, this is the signal. What is the power of even part of the signal? Even part of the signal. So I told you every signal x of t can be expressed as the even part of the signal, even component of the signal plus odd component of the signal. Similarly, the energy of the signal or power of the signal is equal to simply summation of the power of even component of signal plus or energy of even component of the signal plus power of odd components of the signal, power of odd components of the signal. Here, this signal x of t having the Fourier series coefficient is given like this. This is having both even component and the odd component. I told to you, if you consider only even component, the corresponding ck is having the only real part. Oh, so we are required to calculate the power of the even part of x of t. So we have to calculate the power by considering only the real part of this one. Power by considering only this real part of this one. Along with this, we have to consider k equal to 0 also. Since this k equal to 0 is odd number only. Sorry, even number only, k equal to 0 also. We have to consider by considering these components, we have to calculate the power. If they ask you what is the power of the signal x of t, simply total ck value you have to consider. If they ask you what is the odd component, only imaginary part you have to consider to calculate the power. Okay, the power of the signal, energy of the signal equal to power of even components plus power of the odd component. From this way, we can consider by considering the real part of the signal only, ck of real is equal to 10 divided by 3 mod k. Then what is the power of the signal? Already we told you this is equal to simply sigma ck square. Power is equal to simply sigma t ck square. So this is equal to simply sigma c3 square plus simply this is equal to c3 square plus c minus 3 square plus c2 square plus c minus 2 square plus c1 square plus c minus 1 square plus c0 square. This is correct or wrong? here the limits are from mod k less than 3. Mod k less than 3 is nothing but it is not including the value of 3. If it is mod k less than or equal to 3, then you have to consider 3 and minus 3 also. So here it is mod k less than 3 only. You are not supposed to consider c3 and minus 3. It is simply c2 square plus c minus 2 square plus c1 square. The corresponding is equal to simply c2 square and c minus 2 equal to same only. Or otherwise write down equal to 100 divided by 9 into 4 plus 100 divided by 9 into 4 plus 100 divided by 9 plus 100 divided by 9 plus 100. This is the corresponding answer. Whatever you will get, that is your answer. Corresponding equal around 126.7 like that. Around 126 or 127 like that. Don't bother about this answer. Okay, here the concept. Concept is that they asked about the only even component. The corresponding even component only you have to consider. This x of t, the corresponding even component nothing but the ck point of t is the real part of the signal. And imaginary part of the signal is for the all components. So corresponding, correspondingly you can calculate the power or energy or whatever. Okay, they ask for the power. If they ask for the energy, power into the range. The power into the range whatever they have given. Whatever they have given. Now, next one. Write down a note. The signal f of t is represented using a Fourier series expression then the value of this f of t at the discontinuities, the value of this f of t at the discontinuities converges to middle value of the signal f of t. This is one statement in the Fourier series. It is having some derivation also. Derivation is not required. The signal f of t can be represented using a Fourier series. Then the values at the discontinuity of this f of t is converges to the middle value of that expression. That is nothing but the value, if there is a discontinuity, that is the signal f of t having the discontinuity at t equal to t naught, then f of t naught plus f of t naught minus divided by 2. Just the value before f of t plus just the value after f of t divided by 2. Now consider not only Fourier series, you consider the u of t, the signal u of t. What is the value at t equal to 0? In the definition of the u of t itself, u of t is equal to 1. Equal to 1 for t greater than 0. This is not defined at t equal to 0. You can take somebody they will take the value before the t equal to 0, and somebody they will take the value after the t equal to 0, and somebody they will take average of these two. T equal to 0 plus or t equal to 0 minus divided by 2. In generally, we will consider the value after this t equal to 0. Immediately after this t equal to 0, we have considered the value is equal to 1. Okay, similarly at the discontinuities, we cannot define the exact value actually. At the discontinuities, we cannot define the actual value. Here the Fourier series representation point of view. This at the discontinuities, this f of t naught is converges to the middle value or like this f of t plus f of t minus divided by f of t plus or f of t minus divided by 2. Now, consider a question given f of t is equal to t for 0 less than t less than or equal to pi. 0 less than t less than pi. And this is equal to 0 for pi less than t less than 2 pi. Pi less than t less than 2 pi. And the corresponding pi less than t less than 2 pi, or we can say this is equal to from minus pi less than t less than 0 also, because we consider always from one period information only. Like this also you can consider, or this one, whatever, right? 0 from minus pi less than t less than 0, and the expression and the Fourier series expression f of t is given by pi by 4 plus summation k equal to 1 to infinity 1 by pi n square 1 by pi n square into cos n pi minus 1 cos n pi minus 1 into cos nt into cos nt minus 1 by 4 cos n pi sin nt. This is the expression they have given. And the corresponding Fourier series expression is f of t equal to pi by 4 plus this is the expression they have given. Then what is the then ask what is the value of then what is the value of 1 plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by pi square 5 square plus 1 by 7 square plus 1 by 8 square up to so on. Then what is the value of the signal f of t is given as t for 0 to pi and this is 0 for pi, minus pi to 0 and the corresponding Fourier series expression f of t is given as like this pi by 4 plus k is 1 to infinity 1 by pi n square into cos n pi minus 1 into cos nt minus 1 by 4 cos n pi into sin nt sin nt. Then what is the value of 1 plus the sum, the expression the summation 1 plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by pi square plus 1 by 7 square up to so on, this value is equal to how much they are asking. Okay, here we know already if there is any discontinuity, the value at the corresponding discontinuity is equal to just after and just before divided by 2. Just after and just before divided by 2. Here in the one period information Fourier series, we will consider only one period information only. One period information only. In this one period information, it is starting from minus pi continuously. Is there any discontinuity at t equal to 0? There is no. Simply discontinuously, it is increasing. Continuously increasing. At t equal to pi, it suddenly falls to 0. There is nothing but we have a discontinuity at t equal to pi. So we can write this f of pi is equal to f of pi plus f of pi minus divided by 2. Just f of pi plus that value is equal to 0. But f of pi minus this value is equal to pi. This way, just f of pi minus up to f of t equal to t means it is simply a ramp signal only. Simply f of t equal to 2 they have given. That is means it is simply a ramp signal only. So this is equal to 0 plus pi divided by 2. So this value is equal to simply your pi by 2. By substituting this t equal to pi in this expression, what will happen we will see. From this Fourier series expression, this f of pi is equal to pi by 4 plus sigma k equal to simple mathematics only. Here only the point. In this question, the concept is only this point only. So after that, only the simplification only. Simple mathematics. 1 by pi n square. Here n is equal to 1 to infinity. 1 by pi n square cos n pi minus 1 into cos n pi. Cos n pi minus 1 into cos n pi minus 1 by 4. Cos n pi minus 1 by 4 cos n pi sin n pi. Whatever the value of n, sin pi is always 0. Sin pi, sin 2 pi, sin 3 pi always 0. So this term is equal to 0 simply. This term value will be 0 simply. This is equal to pi by 2 minus pi by 4 is equal to 1 by pi sigma n equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n square into again write this one. This is simply 1 minus cos theta only, that is minus 2 sin square n pi by 2 minus 2 sin square n pi by 2 into cos n pi. What is the value of cos n pi? Cos n pi is equal to what? Simply minus 1 whole to the power n. Cos n pi is equal to minus 1 whole to the power n. What about this one, sin square n pi by 2? For sin square n pi by 2, we consider the even values. If you consider the even values of n, this will become 2 pi by 2, this will become pi, 4 pi by 2, 2 pi, 6 pi by 2, 3 pi. All these values will become 0 only, sin pi 0, sin 2 pi 0, sin 3 pi 0. So this value is going to be 0 for the even values, 0 for the even values. What about the odd values? This is equal to 2 by pi, minus 2 by pi into for odd values. Odd value means simply this because of the sin square, so 3 pi by 2 either minus 1 or plus 1 because of the square, that will become plus only. Plus 1 sin pi by 2, sin 3 pi by 2, sin pi by 2, sin 7 pi by 2, wherever, whatever. The values are 1 only. And this minus 1 whole to the power n is nothing but this minus 1 whole to the power odd number is nothing but minus only. So this minus will be rolled out. 2 by pi into for odd numbers is equal to 1 plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by pi square up to so on. So the corresponding value is equal to pi square divided by 8 is equal to our required answer 1 by 3 square plus 1 by pi square plus 1 by 7 square plus up to so on. Simple mathematics only, nothing is there. Here the important is this point only. Important is this point only. Right. Right. Next one more question is there. Right on. Take it off. Given the signal f of t, zero, one, two, three, four, like that, and at two you are having one more impulse also. The impulse also here it is one. Whose strength is equal to minus two? Here amplitude is equal to one. This is the signal they have given. They are asking what is the trigonometric Fourier series coefficient minus A2 is equal to how much? Clearly they are mentioning trigonometric Fourier series coefficient. Okay, but nothing but simply your C, if C is equal to A2 by 2 and A2 equal to 2C2 you can call. Okay, whatever. So minus A2 you are asking. This is the signal they have given. This is looking like a summation of two signals, right? One signal is f of t, another one is the one signal is the triangular pulse, another one is the impulse train, another one is the impulse train. So this you can represent this g of t minus some del of t minus 2kt. Or otherwise minus some signal h of t I am considering. That h of t is this f of t is equal to the signal f of t is equal to the triangular pulse. This is one more question they have given actually. Okay, and the corresponding h of t is equal to like this. This is here to 2, 4, minus 2, minus 4. Corresponding strength is equal to minus 2. Here the amplitude is equal to 1. From this f of t is equal to g of t minus h of t only. This is your g of t. H of t only. Now, you know already, this is of the format del of t minus 2kt. What is the value of the Cn? Cn is equal to simply 1 by t, Cn is equal to simply 1 by t for all values of Cn. For all values of n, the corresponding value is equal to 1 by t only. Right. For C1 or C2 or whatever, we are concentrating on the C2, the corresponding C2 is equal to 1 by 2 only. 1 by 2 is nothing but here amplitude is equal to minus 2. So this value is equal to simply minus 2 divided by 2. This value is equal to minus 1. Minus C2 is equal to minus 1. Directly you can write. How can you write? Oh, already we have seen the first question of the Fourier series is this one only. Exponential series signal del of t minus t. The corresponding Ct, Cn is equal to 1 by t for all values of n. If amplitude is equal to a, the corresponding is equal to a by t for all values of here. Here the signal is h of t is equal to like this. Plus you can consider. The signal. The corresponding here amplitude a is equal to minus 2. So I consider this minus 2 and period is equal to 2 here. So this is simply minus 2 divided by 2, which is equal to minus 1 from this signal. What about this signal? C2 of the h of t that was. What about the C2 of this one? Okay, C2 of this one. For any signal in the Fourier series, first we have to verify whether the given signal is even or odd or having the half a symmetry or like that, By looking, this is not an either even nor odd signal. What type of signal? Even signal. Whether it is satisfying the half a symmetry or not. But simply by considering the half of the period, and we have to move like that. By seeing it is not a By saying it is not satisfying the half wave symmetry, at that situation we have to do some modification. For modification, how can you do? Here the width of this vertical axis is equal to simply 1 minus 0, this equal to 1, this equal width is equal to 1 minus 0, this equal to 1, half of this part is equal to 0.5. So we have to make the signal as like this, the signal as like this. The positive part should be 0.5 and the negative part should be minus 0.5. Considering this as some x of t, considering this as some x of t, by adding simply this x of g of t is equal to t equal to 0.5 plus x of t, we will get the original signal only. 0.5 if we add this one, 0.5 plus 0.5 is 1, 0.5 minus 0.5 is 0. Now the corresponding this is equal to, this is your period 2, this is our period 2, this is our half period 1, half period 1. Now you have to verify whether the signal is satisfying the half asymmetry or not. But how can you verify? Just we draw an imaginary axis about this half period and you have to move like this, you have to move like this and like this. Here this value is equal to some positive value, the corresponding we are having some negative value here. Okay, after crossing this point, you are having some negative value, you are having some positive value. The positive value is symmetry to this one. So this is having the half wave symmetry. Many questions are we have seen till now. Still you are having the doubt, no problem, revise the previous classes. So verification about this topic, about this symmetry property is very, very important in the Fourier series. Okay, the symmetry, just consider the half part and we have to move like this. The corresponding symmetrical value to be available in the positive and negative manner. Here it is positive value, it is negative value. After reaching this one, negative value, positive value. After reaching to this two, the corresponding value is equal to minus 0.5. In reaching to this level, the corresponding value is equal to 0.5. So definitely satisfying the half wave symmetry. So it is having only odd harmonics. This x of t, g of t is equal to your 0.5 plus x of t. This x of t is having only odd harmonics. So the g of t also is having only odd harmonics. Hence the corresponding CT is here is equal to 0. CT is nothing but even harmonic component, the corresponding CT is equal to 0. So from final, the expression for C2 is equal to minus 1. From this A2 is equal to how much? C2 is equal to A2 by 2. A2 is equal to minus 2. Now from this you can write minus A2 is equal to 2. This is one more question only. This much of discussion was there. Still it is one more question only. Because by directly, if we are having more practice on this concept, directly you can say the signal is 0 to 1. Directly you can write this signal and you can say this is a half wave symmetry. The corresponding A2 is equal to 0 definitely for this one. The corresponding A2 for this one is equal to minus 2. Minus A2 is equal to 2 directly you can write.